flap, ठीक है? This is a periosteal elevator. Once I have completely elevated, so I need to extract these two teeth. So I'm elevating the flap completely. This is the interdental call area, and this area also I will be detaching. Anesthesia is also working fine, so no problem. Pause. Now this is basically a luxator or a straight elevator. So I'm going to use this luxator. I'm getting some anchorage here, and I'm using a lever principle. I'm giving leverage. Can you see this tooth is moving? So this is what I'm going to do now, like this. I take the leverage from the interdental bone, not from the adjacent tooth. Here I can take it from the adjacent tooth, because here I also need to extract this one. This patient seeks serial extraction for denture fabrication, complete denture. So now I'm going to, since I have luxated the tooth, now it is time to deliver the tooth. This is basically canine, and first force that you apply with the forceps is the apical force, so that you get a good grip of the tooth. Now any single rooted tooth, you always try to go for a figure 8 motion. This is going to tear apart all the periodontal ligaments, and after that you slowly exert pressure on the buccal plate. If you think you need more luck, I'm going to luxate this one also. Both of these. First force is always apical force, and then this anterior force I'm using. See now the tooth is getting luxated. Canine will have a long root, so you have to be very careful about it. So again, figure 8 motion, and this is comparatively easier. Let's see it has. Now I'm going to squeeze the buccal plate after exploration of the socket and lavage with NS and Vitadin. I'm going to squeeze the socket, check for any bony spicules are present or not, and after that I will be super. The needle holder, and this is, I am using a silk suture. So in this interdental area, the interdental gingiva, this is actually the thing which we are supposed to suture. Most commonly used suture is the simple interrupted. I am also going to use the same thing. So Look at the way I'm holding the forceps. This is the way of holding the forceps. Okay? Unlike other surgical practices, here you don't have much opportunity to rotate your hand. So here all the surgical activities are wrist work. So this is called as a surgeon's knot. First knot should be loose. Second and successive knots are going to be stronger. Okay? Why? Because if your first knot is tight, you can actually tear the gum, that you can tear the flap, which can lead to further bleeding. Okay, so now with the scissor I'm going to cut this thing. And ideally ask patient to take a 4x4, like, you know, you take this 4x4 bulge and you ask the patient to bite onto it. পুরো বলবো হ্যাঁ তো জোরসে কামড় দিন তো আরেকবার ছেড়ে দিন ছেড়ে দিন অলওয়েজ রিলিফ দ্য লিপ ওকে কামড় দিন আবার সিন্স ইট ইজ অ্যানেস্থেটাইজড পেশেন্ট উইল হ্যাভ নো সেন্সেশন অফ দ্য লিপ নিচের ঠোঁটটা ছেড়ে দিন ছেড়ে দিন হ্যাঁ খুব সুন্দর ব্যাস ঠোঁটে কামড় পড়লে ঠোঁটে ব্যথা লাগবে ঠোঁট বন্ধ করে দিন অ্যাসেস দ্য পেশেন্ট লাইক দিস অ্যান্ড নাও What you're going to do is... I'm sure.